For evaluating locations, there are various techniques that can be used, all of these models can be used for varied reasons to identify the ideal location. The popular models that can be used are factor weighting method, centroid method, transportation method, and the cost volume profit analysis. So the first one is the factor weighting method. The procedure of factor weighting method includes the steps. We start with identifying the important location factors. So we had already discussed various factors that are required to be kept in mind while deciding on the location for setting up manufacturing or service facility. Now, each and every factor is not equally important. And for setting up different type of plant or facilities, we need to consider different set of factors. So in the factor rating method, we start with identifying the important factors that are relevant for that particular facility. Second is rate each factor according to its relative importance to the firm. So means on the basis of the importance of a particular factor to the organization, we assign a weight to that particular factor. Developer rating scale for the factor. So this way we assign rating to each and every individual factor. And this rating is strictly on the basis of the relevant importance of that particular factor to the firm. After developing the rating scale for factors, then we give score to each location on each factor based on the score scale. Let's say there is one factor nearness to market and we are considering three locations. Now we'll give score to each location on the basis of this particular factor, nearness to market. Let's say we give score 200 to location A, score 150 to location B, and we give score 50 to the location C, depending upon their nearness to the market. Now, in the next step, now we have got the rating for each factor and you have got the score of each location on each factor. Now, in the next step, you're required to multiply the score with the rate assigned, the rating or the weights assigned to each of the factors. So this will give us the weighted score for each location. Now you need to do the summation of the scores you have just calculated in the last step. And now in the last step, you'll make a recommendation based on the maximum point score considering other factors. Now let's do it with the help of an example. So this is an example. So a particular company is going to decide on the location. They are they are considering two particular locations, location one and location two. Now the rating of each factor is given to you and the score of for each location for each factor is also given to you. So just again recapitulate the points. First of all, identify the important location factors. These are the location factors we have listed out. Then rate each factor according to its relative importance to the firm. Okay, now we have given rating to each factor on the basis of the relative importance to the firm. That means facility utilization is most important factor to the firm. That's why we have given the highest rating to this particular factor. Then sixth rating we have given to the average time per emergency trip. So this is the second most important factor. Third most important is the total patient per month. This is the means we are doing this location analysis for establishing a hospital facility. So total patients per month has been given the rating of 5. So in the next, we have developed a rating score. Now we need to score each location on each factor. So 3 is the score for location 1 for facility utilization and so on. So we have given score. Now in the next step, you're required to multiply the scores by the weights for each vector and total the weighted scores for each location. Now you all are required to do this. Students, you all are required to do this on your notebooks. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So now we have five factors listed over here. So you are required to calculate the weighted score for each of the factor for each location. So first factor is facility utilization. And rating is 8. Similarly, second factor, third, fourth, and fifth. So all the factors are listed on the screen. You just check it out from there. I'll just tell you how to calculate it. So now students, you can clearly see here, these are the ratings given to each factor and these are the scores given to location one for each of the factors. So to calculate the weighted score for location one, we just need to multiply the score with the corresponding rating. So 3 into 8, 24. Similarly, 4 into 5, 20. 6 into 4, 24, then 3, and then 5 fives are 25. Now, after calculating the weighted score for location one, you just need to do the summation of all these weighted scores. So the weighted score for location one comes out to be 96. Now, similarly, in the same manner, now we'll do it for location two. This is for location two. So the total weighted score comes out to 106. So as the score of location two is greater than the score of location one, the weighted score of location two is greater than the location one. So our final selection would be location one. So based on the weighted factor rating we had just calculated, we'll select the location 2 over location 1. Students, note down. A car manufacturing company. A car manufacturing company is considering 2 locations, France and Denmark. The rating points and the rating point and scores assigned to each location are as follows. First factor is labor availability. And attitude. Labor availability and attitude. Next is people to car ratio. People to car ratio. Third factor is per capita income. Per capita income. Fourth is tax structure. Tax structure. Last one is fifth factor is education and health. Education and health. Now, in the next column, write down rating for each of these factors. For the first factor, it is 0.25. For second factor, it is 0.05. For third factor, it is 0.10. For next, it is 0.39. And for last factor, it is 0.21. Now, the scores for location. First location is France and second is Denmark. First of all, write the scores for France. For the first factor, score is 70. For the second, it is 50. For third factor, 85. For fourth factor, 75. And for fifth factor, it is 60. Similarly, for Denmark, it is for the first factor, 60. Second factor, 60.
Hello.
Third factor, 80. Yes.
Ma'am, can you repeat once again the location one for the France?
For the France, the scores are 70, 50, 85, 75, and 60. And for Denmark, it is 60, again 60, 80, and last two are 70. So for the fourth point, score is 70. For the fifth point, it is also 70. So you all have noted down the statement. So try to now you all are required to calculate the weighted score for both the locations and then tell me which particular location will be selected by the company based on this technique, factor rating method. So start calculating, students. Hurry up, students, tell me fast.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, kindly repeat Denmark's score.
Denmark's score are 60. Again 60. 80. 70. And 70.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. The France will be the good location. Location one.
What is the weighted score for France?
70.35.
And for Denmark?
68.
Yeah. So the final selection would be France. Okay, the next method is centroid method. It is also called as center of gravity method. So the centroid method is used for locating single facilities that considers existing facilities, the distances between them, and the volume of goods to be shipped between them. This methodology involves formulas used to compute the coordinates of the two-dimensional point that meets the distance and volume criteria stated above. So, first of all, we calculate two coordinate points to find out the new location. So, when we use centroid method, we do consider the existing facilities that are already there. So This is the formula for calculating the coordinate of x, as I've told you here. So this methodology involves formula used to compute the coordinates of the two-dimensional point. So those two-dimensional points are coordinate of x and coordinate of y. So one dimension is x, another dimension is y. Cx is equal to sigma dixvi over sigma vi. And similarly, coordinate y will be calculated with the formula summation diy vi over summation vi. So where cx is the x coordinate of centroid, cy is y coordinate of centroid, dix is the x coordinate of the ith location, and diy is equal to y coordinate of the ith location. So vi is equal to the volume of goods moved to or from the ith location. So this is the problem given to us. What is the best location for a new Z mobile warehouse or temporary storage facility, considering only distances and quantities sold per month? So these are the existing, so we have to find out the location for a Z mobile warehouse to be established. So now there are already three showrooms of Z mobile, which is A, D, and Q. The number of units to be sold at each of these showrooms are given here. So 1,250 units are sold at the location A, 1,900 units are sold at the showroom D, and 2,300 units are sold at the showroom Q. Now the coordinates of these means this is the two-dimensional plot. This is dimension X and this is the dimension Y. So the coordinates of A, D, Q are already given to us, and we have to find out the coordinates for the new location. So for that purpose, we need to calculate the in the similar manner, like the coordinate X and Y is mentioned here for each location. Now we need to find out the X and Y coordinate of the new location to be established. So means to start with, we need to identify the existing facilities on a two-dimensional plane or grid and determine their coordinates. So first of all, the existing facilities that are there are required to be plot on a two-dimensional grid that we have already done. You must also have the volume information on the business activity at the existing facility. So this information is also with us. So what is the volume of sales at each of these facility? That is also with us. Now, we need to calculate the new coordinates using the formula. So students, just note down the formula. From here, just note down the formula. It will be quite helpful for all of you to calculate the coordinate X and Y with the help of this formula. So, what we are required to do is that we are given X coordinate of location A, D, and Q. And we are given the with the volume of each of the location. So you are required to calculate the summation of product of each of the coordinate of each of the location with the corresponding volume. And then do the summation. Then similar manner, you need to calculate the summation of the volume of all the three locations. And this by using this formula, you will get the coordinate of X. Similarly, for calculating coordinate Y, you need to do the summation of coordinate Y of different locations after multiplying it with their corresponding volume. So hopefully you all have noted down the formula by now. So for calculating the coordinate of x, what you are required to do is, for location A, the coordinate x is 100 and the output is 1250. You need to multiply 100 by 1250. In the similar manner, the coordinate of D will be multiplied by 1900. And the coordinate of means Q 790 is required to be multiplied by 2300. Then divide this by the summation of the volumes at all the three locations. So calculate, all of you. So coordinate CX will be calculated with the help of formula. Student, just make the calculation and tell me the answer. All of you, just do the calculation. So by making the calculation of x and y, we have got the values 443 and 627. And now we'll plot the location z here. So this is the way of calculating with the help of center of gravity method. The next method that can be used for deciding upon the location is the transportation method. So transportation method seeks to minimize the cost of shipping n units to m destinations, or it seeks to maximize profit of shipping n units to m destinations. So students, you will be doing this transportation method in your subject operation research in much detail. So I'll just tell you that the objective of this particular method is to minimize the cost of shipping from one place to another place. Or we are putting it in the other way, it is to see, it seeks to maximize the profits of shipping N units to M destinations. So the positive, the advantage of using this method is that it eliminates subjectivity. So there is no amount of bias in this kind of method, as because we'll solve it with the help of a particular technique, and then whatever answer we get is we have to take the decision based on that. So there is no scope for personal bias, because this is totally an objective type of technique. Another thing is that it may give quite an unrealistic answer, because we just sometimes minimizing transportation cost will not be of much benefit to the organization if we ignore all the other factors that should be considered. So it means if it is not as per the guidelines of the government, laws are not favorable in that particular location that has been selected on the basis of the lowest cost, even then means setting up the manufacturing plant at that place will be of no use to the organization. So it might give unrealistic answer, because it just give focus on single factor, that is the transportation cost involved. So the various further transportation method, the various method that can be used for solving the problem with the help of transportation method is, means for initial solution, we can make use of the least cost entry method. Then we can use Northwest corner method, and then we could use the cost minima method, or which is called Vogel's approximation method. And for finding out the optimum solution, we can make use of any of the Modi method or the stepping stone method. So you all will be doing these methods in detail in your subject operation research. Next. And the last technique that can be used for selecting the location is cost profit volume analysis. So in cost profit volume analysis, what we do is, first of all, it consists of the three steps. First of all, determine fixed and variable cost at each location alternative. Second is plot total cost lines for all location alternatives on the same graph. And third is determine the lowest total cost for the expected level of output. Then you need to find out the total cost for the expected level of the output. So there are a few assumptions that need to be kept in mind while using the cost profit volume analysis. And these assumptions are that fixed costs are constant for the range of probable output, and then variable costs are linear for the range of probable output. Outputs can be closely estimated, and only one product is involved. So for doing cost profit volume analysis, we are considering the location on the basis of a single product. So if a facility is going to produce or manufacture a variety of products, then this particular method cannot be used. So this method can be used assuming that only one product can be manufactured at that particular facility, and output for each of the location can be easily calculated. Fixed cost and are constant, and variable cost, we all know, that keeps on varying as per the volume of the output. So this is an example. Fixed and variable cost for four potential locations for 10,000 units are given. So just keep in mind that this variable cost is for 10,000 units. So you could all of you can just note down, and you can do it along with me. For location A, fixed cost is $2,50,000, and variable cost is $11. You could write in rupees as well. Okay, there is no problem in that. For location, fixed cost is ₹2,50,000 and variable cost is ₹11. For location B, fixed cost is 1 lakh and variable cost is ₹30,000. For location C, fixed cost is ₹1,50,000 and variable cost is ₹20,000. And for location D, fixed cost is ₹2 lakh and variable cost is ₹35,000. So students, have you all noted down?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we have just finished the first step wherein we need to calculate the fixed and variable cost for each of the location. Next, we need to calculate the total cost. Okay, fixed cost, all of you know that it will remain fixed. Okay, no matter whatever the volume of output is, but the variable cost varies with the volume of output. So this is always per unit. So fixed cost is not given as per unit cost. It is free of, it doesn't depend upon the volume of the output produced, but fixed variable cost is generally given as per unit. So to calculate the total cost, first of all, we need to multiply the variable cost given with the number of units. So 11 is the variable cost per unit for location A, and the units produced are 10,000. So our variable cost will be 11 into 10,000. That is 1,10,000. Similarly, for location B, the variable cost is 30 per unit and number of units are 10,000. So it comes out to be 3 lakh. For location C, your variable cost is 20, number of units are 10,000, so your variable cost comes out to be 2 lakh. And similarly, for location D, your variable cost comes out to be 3,50,000. Now, for calculating total cost, you just need to do summation of the fixed cost and the variable cost. For location A, your fixed cost is 2,50,000. And variable cost is 1,10,000. So the total sum total of these two will be 3,60,000. Similarly, for location B, fixed cost is 1 lakh and variable cost is 3 lakh. So total cost will be 4 lakh. For location C, fixed cost is 1,50,000. Variable cost is 2 lakh. So the total cost will be 3,50,000. For location D, fixed cost is 2 lakh, variable cost is 3,50,000. So the total cost is 5,50,000. Now we have got the total cost for each of the location. Next, we need to plot these means cost on a graph. So this is the graph we have plotted. On the horizontal axis, we have taken the annual output, and on the vertical axis, we have taken the cost of the output. So now this 2 means 2,000 units, 4,000 units, 6,000, because annual output is given in 1,000. Okay? So 6,000, 8,000, 10,000, 12,000, 14,000 and 16,000. Similarly, on the y-axis, the value is given in 1,000. So this 100 means 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh, 4 lakh, 5 lakh, 6 lakh, 7 lakh, 8 lakh. So this is the cost of the output. So for plotting the value on graph, what we need to do is you need to identify the fixed cost, because at the zero level of output, our total cost will be fixed cost, because fixed cost has to be incurred even if there is no production going on. Fixed cost is something that has to be incurred, but variable cost will be incurred only if some process is going on. So at the zero level of output, our fixed cost, our total cost, So students, now the fixed cost, we had to start plotting from the fixed cost, and then we have to locate the means the cost. So 360,000 is the cost for A. So for A location, $360,000 will come somewhat here, and the fixed cost is 250,000. So the fixed cost is this 250,000, and the highest cost is 360,000. So this is the way we'll plot the graph. Now, after plotting the lines of total cost, you what now just have a look. This is the this gray line is of B. This light gray line is of location C. Black is of location A, and this yellow is the line of D. If you look, the cost is minimum till this point of location B. As this is the line of location B, this is the minimum out of the cost of all the four locations till this particular point. Now, after this point, what happens? The cost of C is the lowest, and it will go up till this particular point. And again, from this point onwards, the cost of A becomes the minimum. Now, as per the cost profit volume analysis, means a particular location will be favorable up to a respective volume of output. So till this 5,000 units, B is superior location as compared to all the other locations. Till this 11,000 units, this means between 5,000, if our output we are going to consider falls between 5,000 and 11,000, then C is a preferable location. And if our means the cost is above 11, if the volume of output will be greater than 11,000, then A is a preferred location in that scenario. So this particular method will analyze a location based on the cost as well as the volume. So that's why it's termed as the cost profit volume analysis. A particular location can be favorable only till a particular number of units. So we can do this analysis as till this particular means point, only B is the superior. From this particular point, two locations that are intersecting between each other, that is B and C, has to be considered. So the formula for this is total cost of C is equal to total cost of B. So the quantity, the total, this will be 150,000 plus 20 into quantity, 20 into 10,000. And this is 1 lakh plus 30 Q. And so instead of 10,000, we have written Q to simplify this. So 50,000 is equal to 10 Q. So the quantity comes out to be 5,000. So till 5,000, B is superior, and above 5,000, this C will be superior. And now from the next, there will be a comparison between C and A. Because these two lines are intersecting, so now we have to make the comparison between A and C, and the quantity comes out to be 11,101 units. So means between 5,000 and 111 units, C will be a preferable location, and above 11,112 units, we can consider the location A. In the similar manner, just like we did it here. Students, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Students, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Students, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Students, just note down. Company is considering 3 locations to set up their firm's facility. So these 3 locations are Akron, 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 second location is Bowling Green, and third is Chicago. Now I'll note down the fixed cost and variable cost for each of these locations. So the volume of output is 2000 units, 2000 units. So students, just have a look. There are 3 locations. First is Akron, second is Bowling Green, and third is Chicago. Fixed cost for each of these are, for Akron, it's 30,000 rupees. For Bowling Green, it's 60,000 rupees. And for Chicago, it's 110,000. And variable cost for Akron is rupees 75. For Bowling Green, it's rupees 45. And for Chicago, it's rupees 25. So the volume of output considered is 2000 units. So you all are required to solve this, and I'll ask you about this in the next lecture. So you are required to solve this and tell me the answer in the next lecture.